Hello and welcome to the session of Filter Aids in Pharmaceutical Process. This is Suresh Kumar Paswan, Assistant Professor in Department of Pharmacy, SGS-ITS, Indore. Today we are going to discuss filter aid in pharmaceutical process. Talking about filtration, it is very important unit operation in our pharmaceutical area. It is used in filtration of slurries, preparation of syrups. It is used in aseptic processing. So it is used in syringe filters, it is used in bulk drug industries where the solid is separated from the liquid. So it's a very important unit operation in our pharmaceutical area. Talking about filtration, it's a process in which solid is separated from the fluid with the help of septum. So septum, this is called filter media. Let us see. So this is a septum, it is a filter media. The filter paper what we are using is known as septum, and the solid free fluid which is obtained is filtrate. So this portion is called filtrate, and the deposit of the solid formed on the septum, so whatever it is deposited or residues which are obtained is known as septum or cake. So next, talking about filtration process. So normally when we go for filtration, what happens, like if the solution we are going to filter, the slurry will come, the solution, the filtrate, it will come down from this particular area. This is the filter paper or the septum, and the cap which is present over here, the solution, it will come, and the solid, the substance, it will remain on the surface. So what happens after some times, like after a few minutes or few hours, the solid particle, it goes and clogs this pores. So all the pores are been clogged over here, and gradually it reduces the rate of filtration, and slowly it will stop the filtration process. So what happens, like we use filter aids to prevent the filter media from getting clogged. So these filter aids, these are the external substance which we use to mix into the solution, or we use to prepare a pre-coat by which the rate of filtration is increased. So filter aids, these are the solid substance or the powder which are used as a which used to prevent the medium from getting clogged. So talking about the application of filter aids, like there are two kind of application. One is pre-coat application, another one is pre-mix filter. So talking about pre-coat, so as we know, this is a filter media or the filter paper, and this area is the pores which are present over here. So these are the pores, and these small white particles, these are all called filter aids. So this filter aid, it separates this particular substance. This is our solid particles, and this portion, this white portions, these are all called filter aids. So they prepare some fine channels by which the liquid, it will slowly percolate and filter through your media. So here all the liquid, it will slowly, it will move down, and the process of clogging, it will be reduced. So likewise, we are making a pre-coat. In pre-coat, what we are doing, we are preparing a slurry, and we are filtering those slurry of filter aid, and then we are filtering our slurries or the desired slurries. Another one is premix. In premix, what we used to do, we used to add filter aid to the slurry. So what happened, these white particles, if you see, these are all filter aids, and it forms a tortuous path for the liquid to go down. So if this is a filter media or filter paper, we're having gap over here, slowly the solution, it will move down and will go down. So what happens, in pre-mix, the slurry, the filter aid is mixed with the slurry, and they find fine paths for the solution to move down, and the rate of filtration is increased or it is improved. So talking about the ideal properties of the filter aid, these are these should be chemically inert. It should not react with your solution. Like in our pharmaceutical area, what we used to do, we used to take organic solvents, so it should not react with with the solution, and it should not be compressible. The generally what happens, like whatever the material what we are using, if it compresses, it will go and block the pores. Like here, if it compresses, then it will block the pores. So it should be not compressible, and it should be insoluble with the filter media. It should not be soluble. If it is soluble, then it will stop acting. It should be used over wide range in pressure drop. Like in pharmaceutical area, we used nitrogen pressure, so it should be used in various high pressure areas also. It should be economic. Surely it should be economic. It should not have big cost. So it will increase the cost of our pharmaceutical preparations. It should not prepare impart fiber of the particle. The fiber, if we are using fiber or particle, it should be big enough so that it should be filtered through that particular filter paper, and it should be non-toxic. It should not react with the solution. It should not impart its toxicity into the solution. So there are some examples of the filter aids. There are various substances which are used as a filter aid, like Kieselguhr, diatomic earth matter, charcoal, kaolin, asbestos cellulose, volcano glass, perlite and bentonite. These are some classical examples of filter aids. Talking about Kieselguhr, if you'll see Kieselguhr, if you take this powder of Kieselguhr and observe over microscope, you'll find very fine structures. What is Kieselguhr? Actually, it is a diatomic earth matter or fossilized powder. So fossilized, as you know, the algae which is present there in the sea, it gets deposited down, and if you see the structure, it is around 50 micron structure, and in 50 micron you see very fine pores are there. These are the structure, cellular structure of that algae, and after remaining in the for long period or fossilized time, what happened, this algae it is mineralized and it becomes solidified. And these are now used as a Kieselguhr powder. So these powder, they are having very fine structures, and this fine structure, very fine pores are there. So these pores help us in increasing the rate of flow, or it form channels and it increases the rate of flow of the liquid. Another one is charcoal. In charcoal also, you see fine structures, fine pores are there. The wood is heated to very high temperature, in which all the moisture or the cellular substance, it diffuses out, and only the cell wall is there. So you will see very fine structures are there, or fine pores are there, which increase the rate of filtration. Another one is perlite. This is volcano glass. Again, it is also having very fine structures, fine fine pores are there, and again it will help increase. Asbestos, it is having very fine like a fiber kind of substance, so it will entrap the particle above itself, so it will act like that. Another one is bentonite. Bentonite, it acts in a separate way. Bentonite, what happens, it actually there are two kind of substance solutions are there, flocculated and deflocculated suspensions are there. In deflocculated, you will find here very hard cake has been formed. So nothing is added over here. Your only fine powders are there, and this hard cake, it will again it will reduce the rate of filtration. So what we do, we used to add very small quantity of bentonite, so it will form a flocculated kind of suspension. So flocculated suspension, it will form loose flocules, and there will be channels, paths. All these paths, it will help us to increase in rate of flow, because the slurry or the solution, it will move across through this tortuous path and it will go down, and likewise it will increase the rate of filtration, and and it will stop producing very hard cake on the surface of filter medium. Some part is taken by American Filtration Separation Society by Wu Chen. I acknowledge him, and thank you for listening.